Sam Kavaris, Gary Smits, the golf writer for the Florida Times Union. How many is this for you? How
Sam, this will be my, with three different newspapers, this will be 29.
29, yeah. Fantastic. It's certainly changed over the years. And, you know, a lot of people don't realize that this tournament, when it was invented by Dean Beaman, was played at Inverary in February once.
Yes.
It was played in August once
in Atlanta,
right? So moving it around is not anything really foreign to this tournament. Now back, obviously, in March. And, you know, it wasn't until 83 that they settled on the last week of March.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, in 82, they actually played this week in March when Jerry Page ended up winning.
We are closer to the true time of March.
Yeah, much closer. So 17, obviously, the most photographed hole in the world, the signature hole of the golf course. Is it fun to cover this hole? Because people like our friend and colleague Doug Ferguson occasionally have said, oh, this is one of the things that's holding it back from being a more significant tournament.
I don't think it's holding it back from, certainly from a fan standpoint, who's actually, they're actually here.
Here, right.
And whether or not you like the hole, whether or not you agree with the architecture on this, it's there and it's going to define this tournament.
Right.
For good or ill, almost every year. And yes, it's fun to be out here because in one swing, somebody's dreams could be realized or shattered.
Len Matisse.
Yes.
Right?
Len Matisse. Sean O'Hare.
Sean O'Hare. Same thing.
Right. Phil Blackmore. Hit in the water, had a chance to win this thing one time.
Yep.
Bob Tway. Now, Bob Tway wasn't in contention, but Bob Tway had a very, very bad morning here with making a 12.
Eduardo Romero, I remember, made a 7 here.
And I was talking to Paul, and again, we were at a conversation with Paul Azinger, who's the only guy to have ever birdied this hole 4 days in a row.
Wow.
And he made a hole-in-one here in 2000. He said it was an out-of-body experience. He said, I was so self-conscious with the cheering after the hole-in-one. He said, I felt funny walking to the hole.
Yeah, I'm sure.
So, Sam, you played this course enough time, and you're unlike me, you're a good enough golfer to be a little bit closer to what they're feeling out there. But in May, it was a predominantly south wind.
Yep.
Okay. We're getting a west-northwest wind right now. It's coming like this. We're going to get one more like the east-northeast or the northeast over here,
right,
probably during the tournament, which is going to be the predominant wind in March. What's going to be different about the way they played this? For somebody who only saw this tournament in May, what's going to be different about how they're going to play this hole now?
You know, what's fascinating, you talk to a guy like Ricky Fowler, who I said to him when he birdied it, you know, three times in a row to win, including in the playoff. I said, what'd you hit there? He said, choke up three-quarter gap wedge. Remember that?
Yep.
He said that constantly, right? You can't do that anymore. And in television, we call this the hairometer, right?
Yep.
Right? So it's kind of, you can see it's blowing this way. Well, there's the green.
Mm-hmm.
People don't actually recognize how different this is going to be even from before 2007, because they put these hospitality suites up here that shield some of the wind. They're also along 16, but they're not in that gap right there that's over the green.
Yes.
And if you're up there by the green, oftentimes you'll see a ball go up, and it looks like it's going to turn over and land on the green. Instead, it falls straight back into the water because on the tee, you can't feel the wind up there. So, I mean, we've seen players hit 5-iron here when the wind's really blowing.
Yep.
But from 132 yards or 137, which is what it is officially, you know, we're talking 9-irons and wedges. But if the wind blows, it puts that doubt in players' minds. And that's the only thing that the best players in the world ever succumb to.
One thing they can't control.
That's right.
And now, and just by coincidence, today, I don't know if they did this just for us, the tour, but the Sunday pin is in
there. It's over there on the right side.
Right over the bunker on the right side. Now, there have been some very heroic shots here. We all remember David Duval, the second Jacksonville native to ever win this, along with Mark McCumber, who pulled a wedge and stuck it right up there, let it trickle down. Nick, and he was trying to duplicate the shot Nick Price hit in 1993. He specifically mentioned that was one of the greatest shots he'd seen under pressure, and that was his swing thought. But how many guys, David Duval, that time in his career, the ball was, he couldn't have pointed any straighter than he was hitting it.
Yeah, then he was hitting it.
Okay?
Yeah.
But if you're a guy and you got a chance to win this, and maybe you're not hitting it as well as David Duval was in 1999, and he was the best in the world at that time, where are you going to aim that ball? Are you going to just go to the middle of the pin?
Try to hit it at the spine and let it roll down there, which is what a lot of guys try to do. You know, Freddie Couples, the first time he won it, hit sand wedge here.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so the wind wasn't blowing that day, if you remember, on the final day. My favorite comment about this was in '86, I played in the Pro-Am with Cal Pete the year after he won. And he was living in Jacksonville at the time, and we were walking from 16 to 17. And I said to him, hey, last year when you came here in the final round and you knocked it on, what were you thinking? And he said, I was just thinking, I'm glad I don't have to hit that again.
And then the famous Mark McCumber quote, that was the best way to play 17 with a four-shot lead.
That's right.
All right. Well, that's again, whether it's in March or May, this is still going to be the keyhole. It's just going to be very, very different as far as the wind is concerned. There's going to be more variety in club selection. Guys, as Sam mentioned, we're hitting gap wedges, even sand wedges out here. I can see somebody, even a long hitter, pulling out an 8 or 9.
Yeah, absolutely.
Three quarters, 8 or 9
absolutely.
Iron. So I think it's going to be more entertaining. Billy Horschel, I was talking to him a couple weeks ago. He said there will be more balls in the water in March than there have been in May. Depending on whether you like, you're the type of person that goes to Daytona for the car wrecks. You come here.
This might be the spot for you.
The balls in the water, exactly. But you know what? Before anybody wins this tournament, they're going to have to hit that shot four times and going to have to probably hit it pretty well.
Exactly.
Gary Smith's here. Sam Kavars, Jacksonville.com. We'll talk to you later.